Springfield, 500 miles. As, not to be confused with, when I wake up and I get home next to you, I'm gonna be the man who said the Scottish song. Hey, lad! It's not that one. But that song that we played, Choo Choo Mama. Go backwards in time. I'm gonna take the notes out of it. I'm gonna tell the story I told yesterday. So when I was a kid, you know, I was heavily influenced by the Beatles. And then the next band after that that I thought was really cool was Led Zeppelin, because man, they laid it all. They had some power. And the blues and the songs and the subject matter, I thought, man, these guys are geniuses how they write these songs. And then I found out they were getting them from the early black blues players like Robert Johnson, Howlin' Wolf, Son House, B.B. King, guys like that, Muddy Waters. And those guys, I started reading back further back in time. I wanted to learn how to play this music. And I learned that those guys got most of their rhythms that inspired them, got people going, doing the hoochie-coo and the rock and roll, which is slang for other crazy behavior in that lexicon. I heard they got it from walking up the railroad tracks. So when I was a kid, I used to walk the track between Temple and Laureldale back and forth, because I lived in Laureldale. My grandparents lived 2.5 miles up the tracks on Hay Road in Temple. And of course, I didn't walk when a train was actually coming. I was smart enough to get off the rail with a bank up. You come up with those rhythms, and the faster you walk, the better the rhythms were. And it turned out that that became rock and roll. Like, but now if you strip away the notes, I'm just going to play the rhythm. Ooh, you can hear that engine running down the track. Hear that engine coming back. You can hear the rails, the rhythm of the rails. Sweet music to me, baby. Oh, hail rock and roll, hail rock and roll, hail rock and roll. And that's where you end up like this. So that's where those guys got that. And that turned into rockabilly music. Early country music and early African-American blues-inspired music was recorded by guys like Sam Phillips at Sun Records down in Memphis, Tennessee. He was trying to find a way to get that music and that groove to people so they could hear it. And he found a couple of boys. He found Elvis Presley. He found Jerry Lee Lewis. He found Roy Orbison. He found Johnny Cash. And he found Carl Perkins. I'm going to just show you a little bit about how Carl Perkins used that same rhythm, modify it a little bit to sound like this. Same rhythm. Here's the rhythm. Let's hear the rhythm. And he had a big hit song. And even the Beatles later on copied his song. Well, I'm sitting here wondering if a matchbox will hold up my clothes. I'm sitting here wondering if a matchbox will hold up my clothes. Well, I ain't got no match, but I sure got a long way to go. I'm an old fool, and I'm a long, long way from home. home of the Reading Railroad. Hanging out in Reading for a few days, but the beer was good and cheap. Places like Stanley's. 5 cents for a beer, 15 cents for a shot.